In this video, we are going to go over the external anatomy of a leaf. The leaf consists of the petiole. This is the stalk that attaches the leaf to the plant stem. At the base of the petiole, there can be leaf-like appendages called stipules. The main part of the leaf is called the leaf blade or lamina. The leaf blade has a base where it connects with the petiole and an apex at the tip of the blade. Veins branch out through the blade of the leaf. The edges of the blade of the leaf is called the margin. The margin can be smooth, toothed, wavy, or lobed. The venation can be pinnate, like in this example with a central midrib that branches out like a feather. It can also be palmate, where it has several main veins extending out from the base of the leaf, with further branching of smaller veins from each of these. The venation can also be parallel, where several large veins run next to each other from the blade base to the apex. In some leaves, such as in needle leaves, there is very little venation at all, and the few veins present are center veins, found running through the inner center of the blade. The leaf can also differ on the number of leaf blades present. This leaf is a simple leaf, as it only has a single blade. Those leaves with more than one blade are called compound leaves. These blades are called leaflets. A compound leaf can have a palmate pattern, where all leaflets grow from the tip of the petiole. These are called palmate compound leaves. A compound leaf can also have a pinnate pattern, where the leaflets are found on each side of a central stalk called the rachis. These are called pinnate compound leaves. In addition, the leaf can be a double compound leaf. In these leaves, the leaflets are also divided into sets of even smaller leaflets. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe for more videos like this one.